Three-dimensional trigonometry. We live in a 3D world, so real-world trigonometry problems cannot always be expressed in two dimensions. In fact, more often than not, we need our diagrams to represent information in three dimensions. All 3D and 2D problems can be resolved into single triangles, where information can be passed from one triangle to the other. We must remember to work with one triangle at a time, though, and where triangles or lines touch and share a common length, we are able to transfer information into another triangle. Transforming a 3D object into a 2D perspective. It's not easy to project a 3D object into an accurate 2D representation by hand. To fully understand 3D space, you need to be aware that there exists a 3D coordinate system. While the 3D coordinate system is not for CAPS exam purposes, we briefly introduce it at this point for purposes of this lesson and to improve your understanding of 3D trigonometry. By this stage, you should be familiar with the 2D coordinate system, where points are plotted on the Cartesian plane using x and y coordinates to indicate its position in the xy plane and distance from each of the axes. 3D coordinate system. If we construct an additional number line of real numbers called the z-axis, that is perpendicular to both the x and y axes, we get a 3D coordinate system. The three axes intersect at one point called the origin. In a 3D coordinate system, a point is located in space rather than on a line or a 2D plane. The points are represented as ordered triples by x, y, and z coordinates, which indicate its position in 3D space and show the point's distance from each axis. Remember, all three axes are number lines and hence have positive and negative values associated with it. The three axes produce three coordinate planes as follows. The xy plane is made up of the x and y axes. The yz plane is made up of the y and z axes. The xz plane is made up of the x and z axes. The three coordinate planes divide space into eight separate parts called octants. Hence, when you are required to solve 3D trig problems, you must not work in more than one triangle at a time, as you will be working across different planes. Example 1. Calculating lengths using 3D trig. Let's apply what we've learned about the 3D coordinate system to a 3D trig problem. A room is in the shape of a cuboid, as shown in the diagram. The room is 5 meters long, 3.5 meters wide, and 3 meters high. Diagonal AF runs from the corner of the floor to the opposite corner of the ceiling, and diagonal AC is drawn from one corner of the floor to the opposite corner of the floor. Calculate the angle formed between diagonal AF and the floor of the room ABCD, correct to one decimal place. Solution. The side AC is important since it is the common side of two different triangles in two different planes. Hence, we can use AC to transfer information from one triangle to the other. We can draw a representation of the 3D problem as shown in this diagram. To calculate the angle FAC, we first need to calculate the length of side AC. FC is perpendicular to the plane, that's the floor, ABCD. First, work in triangle ABC and calculate length AC, and then transfer that information into triangle AFC to calculate the angle theta. Since ABC is a right-angled triangle, we can use the theorem of Pythagoras to calculate the side AC. AC squared is equal to AB squared plus BC squared. Substituting values for AB and BC as 5 and 3,5 respectively, we get AC squared equals 37,25. To find the length of AC, square root both sides of the equation and use your calculator to get AC equals 6,103 and so on, but do not round off just yet. Now that you have the side that links the two triangles, work in triangle AFC to calculate the angle theta. Since triangle AFC is right-angled, we use the definition of tan theta. Tan theta is equal to opposite over adjacent. Therefore, tan theta is equal to the ratio FC over AC. Substitute values for FC and AC, and use your calculator to get theta is equal to 26,2 degrees. Therefore, the angle formed between diagonal AF and the floor of the room ABCD is 26,2 degrees. Example 2, working with variables in 3D trig. In the figure, Q, T, and R are points in the horizontal plane such that TQ equals TR equals Y, and TP represents a vertical pole positioned at T. Question 2.1. If the angle of elevation of P from Q is alpha and angle PRQ is equal to beta, show that PQ is equal to PR. Question 2.2. Express PQ in terms of Y and a trig ratio of alpha. And question 2.3. Prove that QR is equal to the ratio 2Y cos beta divided by cos alpha. Solution. Let's start by filling in the given information on the diagram. TQ and TR are both Y, the angle of elevation of P from Q is alpha, and angle PRQ is equal to beta. For 2.1, we need to work in the triangle with the most information to get the length of PQ, and the same for PR. In triangle PQT, angle T is 90 degrees. TP is a vertical pole. Therefore, PT is perpendicular to QT. We can use the theorem of Pythagoras to get PQ squared is equal to PT squared plus QT squared. Since QT is equal to Y, we get PQ squared equals PT squared plus Y squared. Now let's find an expression for side PR, working in triangle PTR and using Pythagoras once more, we find that PR squared equals PT squared plus RT squared. Therefore, substituting RT as Y, we can simplify to get PR squared equals PT squared plus Y squared. This is the same as the expression for PQ we worked out earlier, hence PQ is equal to PR. For 2.2, to find an expression for PQ using trig ratios, we work in right-angled triangle PQT. By definition, cos alpha is adjacent over hypotenuse. Therefore, cos alpha equals QT over PQ. We can replace QT in the equation with Y. Multiply both sides of the equation by PQ and divide by cos alpha. You get PQ in terms of Y, and a trig ratio of alpha is Y divided by cos alpha. For 2.3, you will need the ratios and conclusions from 2.1 and 2.2. In triangle PQR, we have found that side PQ is equal to PR. Therefore, triangle PQR is an isosceles triangle, and angle PQR is equal to angle PRQ, both equal beta. Using the sum of angles of triangles, we get that angle P is equal to 180 degrees minus 2 beta. Since we have PQ and two angles in triangle PQR, we can use the sine rule to work out an expression for side QR. QR over sine of angle P equals PQ over sine of angle PRQ. Substituting values for the two angles, we get QR over sine of 180 degrees minus 2 beta is equal to PQ over sine beta. Simplifying, we get QR over sine 2 beta, since sine of 180 degrees minus 2 beta is equal to sine 2 beta by reduction formula. And that's equal to PQ over sine beta. Multiply both sides of the equation by sine 2 beta to get QR by itself on the left-hand side. So you get QR is equal to PQ multiplied by sine 2 beta and divided by sine beta. We found an expression in 2.2 for side PQ. Now we can substitute that into our equation. So QR is equal to Y over cos alpha multiplied by 2 sine beta cos beta by using the double angle expansion for sine 2 beta, all divided by sine beta. We can simplify further by cancelling out the common factors of sine beta in the numerator and denominator and get QR is equal to 2y times cos beta, all divided by cos alpha.